Hey guys, it's Mommy Tang. What's up, Tang Gang? Guys, I just came back from LA. I was there for like a little bit longer than a week. Alone! Oh my goodness. There's so much to tell you. Today's recipe is really not a recipe, but while I was in LA, every day I had green juice. Doesn't matter where I went, there was like smoothie place or juice place or something like that. And oh my gosh, yeah, I had green juice almost every day and I felt amazing. Like really, because usually when I'm at home, you know, sometimes I sneak in little junk food here and there and stuff like that. But when I was in LA, I didn't have my kids with me. So I ended up eating a lot of healthy food. And part of it was a green juice. And I just wanted to share, you know, the recipe with you. On top of that, I wanted to share, you know, what happened to me while I was in LA and why I was in LA. And there's a couple of announcements that I want to make for you guys. So, shall we get on with it? Okay, so we have some ingredients. Now, I've done green smoothies before. When I make a green smoothie, I use a little bit of fat, meaning I use almond milk and, you know, maybe, you know, seeds in there, stuff like that. But this is like fat-free. You know what I mean? It's like pure fat-free. So, let's see what we should do. For green juice, but look how amazing, guys. Look at this. Nice. Yum. I think I'm gonna put some spinach in there. You know, I don't know, spinach is good for you, isn't it? Why are you asking questions, Mommy Tang? Don't you know that already? Guys, for real, if you drink like this every day, it's gonna, oh my god, it's gonna be so beneficial to your diet or your health. They say milk does you good. I don't think so. Yeah, so I was in LA first. I want you to, okay. I was in LA, Veg Fest LA, a couple months ago, and I met up with Mr. and Mrs. Vegan. And they invited me to LA Veg Fest. So I did a live mukbang there and I met, oh my gosh, so many of you guys there. I was so touched. Everybody came to me and gave me a hug. We took some selfies, some pictures. You know who you are. And I was so touched. And I just, you know, every one of you that came and said hi to me, I was really, really honored to meet you all. And when I was there, I did a lot of damage to the vegan community. I'm going to tell you about those. Oh, there's so many things in my mind. I don't even know what to start. But first thing that I did in LA that was very memorable was that I was in LA at the Veg Fest. It gave me a lot of ideas. I noticed that there are small companies that are vegan and trying to do something for the vegan movement, you know, and sometimes they need some sort of platform to get it out. You know what I mean? And I figure I have a platform. Yeah, so I figured I want to help you guys, some of you guys. Yeah, I don't know if it's everybody, but what I'm going to do is I'm going to open a P.O. box for you guys, and you guys could send me stuff and I'll do a product review on my show. Wouldn't that be great? So if you can afford, you know what I mean, to, you know, because sometimes when you have a company, the marketing and everything, it costs a lot of money. So if you're a really, really small company and vegan, send me some product, P.O. box. You know, maybe when I get it, I'll do a product review for you. I think it'll be interesting for me from my perspective and also from the viewer's perspective and the whole vegan community. That was one idea that I thought of when I was in LA. Number two, I also veganized a restaurant when I was there. Yes, there's a restaurant called In Korean Town in LA, and they made awesome jajangmyeon. You know the jajangmyeon, the black noodle that I always eat? Yeah, they have a vegetarian option other than, you know, jajangmyeon and stuff like that. So I, together with the owner, and I told him, I said, hey, why don't you make vegan jajangmyeon and vegan jjampong and vegan tangsuyuk, vegan gampugi? You know, those are all the stuff that, you know, Koreans love to eat at a Korean Chinese restaurant. And he said, sure, why not? He is going to actually veganize some of the menu, and he's going to even make free vegan kimchi. And if you come in and say, hey, I'm here for Mommy Tang's menu, you're going to get 10% off on any vegan dishes. Isn't that amazing? So that was the second amazing thing that I did in LA. Number three, I met up with Lisa Carlin. She is co-producer of Lunch Break Live on Facebook. Lunch Break Live. I can't memorize stuff like this. Sorry, Lisa. Lunch Break Live and Food for Life instructor with PCRM. Yes, she was the one that was helping me throughout the whole Veg Fest, the little life mukbang, the learning kitchen. She was wonderful. Oh my goodness. Me and her, we had some deep talks, girlfriend, and it was amazing. And so she invited me to Jane Velez Mitchell's live Facebook interview, and I did an interview with them. And she, Jane Velez Mitchell, is also a nationally known TV journalist, and best-selling author covering crimes against people and animals. So she's like an activist, you know? And she speaks for the voiceless animals. So when I met up with Lisa, Jane, and Donna, oh my gosh, you know, it really, really got to me here. And I just thought of a lot of things that was, you know, that I didn't know. It was kind of awakening for me. So, you know, I thank them. That was another amazing thing that happened to me. And while I was there, I actually did a little photo shoot, you guys. It was amazing, yeah, because LA is like Instagram and YouTube and all that stuff. So I met up with this amazing photographer. I met her, you know, we were just, one night we went out for dinner and we were just chatting, and she was like, yeah, I'll give you a photo shoot. I was like, what? And so she gave me a photo shoot. And then at the same table, there was another famous celebrity, like stylist. She styles like for these amazing like magazines and, you know, models and stuff. And she's like, yeah, let me get on with it too, girlfriend, and I'll style you for free and we could do a photo shoot. I was like, what? So they actually gave me a whole photo shoot. And it was amazing, you guys. I went all out, you guys. I was like twirling, and I was like, you know, like I was like, I felt like something, like a model or something, but I wasn't, like an old model, I guess. And it was amazing. LA was amazing, you know? And yeah, so, oh, and another amazing thing was I had an interview with Wow Cow. They gave me a little interview, so I'll put a link underneath that as well. And that was awesome too, because they were just like, I just noticed that there were so many genuine people around that you could meet, and it was really nice. I also got to meet Ravana. I believe I met High Carb Hannah. I mean, she was my friend, but you know. And I met a friend, her name was Brenda. She was so sweet. She helped me throughout the whole Veg Fest. It was it was just the volunteers that helped me out. You know who you are. And oh my gosh, it was amazing. I also met Victoria. So I just met so many people. But I was on a YouTube platform with Happy Healthy Vegan, I believe. Supreme Banana was there, and then there was a whole bunch of people that I met, and I was actually sad that I didn't get to some of the people. I really wanted to meet Robert Cheeks. I never got to meet him. Steve O was there. I never got to meet him. I was pretty sad about that. I never saw Vegan Cheetah was supposed to be there. I didn't meet him. I don't know why, but I just wanted to meet Vegan Cheetah, and I was actually looking for him because he said somewhere in his video that he was gonna have an umbrella or some sort, but I was looking, but I couldn't see him. But you know, so it was very interesting. The whole LA trip was very interesting. I feel like I'm forgetting probably somebody. I probably am. I really am sorry if I'm forgetting someone, but I met up with a lot of you know, companies, Asian Korean companies, and I tried to tell them how vegan was amazing and they should bring up some more vegan items. So I met up with Ashi, and Ashi provided with us with the tteokbokki, and I made a tteokbokki at the that was my menu for my mukbang there. And I think there was like more than 100 150 people. They had all sampled the tteokbokki from Ashi. Mother-in-law was there, of course, and she provided some kimchi, free kimchi tasting. That was amazing. I met the mother-in-law, the actual mother-in-law. I met her. That was an amazing experience as well. And Nongshim gave us, I think, the 300 vegan ramyeon. We ended up giving it to all the people that came to see me or to see the mukbang, you know. So it was just we did a lot of giveaway. There was Snack Fever. Snack Fever is a company. I'll do a little, I'm going to do a video about that, but Snack Fever is a little company that they sell all these Korean snacks. But I told them, yo, you need to come up with the vegan line, you know what I mean? So they're working on that. They're gonna do a little vegan line there. So it's just to have regular companies that come into the vegan movement, and they know that it's vegan is another thing. That was amazing experience. And then I also met up with Thrive Market CEO. Yeah, Thrive Market CEO. He wanted to meet me. So we had a meeting, and it was very, yeah, so it was just very big eye-opening for me, you know? And this could have never happened, never, unless you guys were behind me, helping me out. I mean, you guys are the ones that put me in this crazy platform. And I just figure, like I said, it's time for me to give back, and I don't know how exactly right now, but I figure instead of, you know, giving spotlights to big companies and all these stuff like that, because, you know, when I cook and stuff like that, I do a lot of product views, you know, that I show you guys what product this is and stuff like that. But I would love to help a small vegan YouTubers, or, you know, small platform that are plant-based, cruelty-free, whatever. I would love to help you guys out. So, like I said, P.O. Box, hit me. And, you know, I will try my best to help you out. So, guys, it was amazing. I know I'm forgetting something. I know, because I was, oh yeah, oh my gosh, this is another thing. Oh my gosh, the video went off. I don't even know where it got cut off. But when I was on the plane back home, I met, I was sitting beside this gentleman, and, you know, we didn't really talk throughout the whole trip, whatever. And then towards the end, we were about to get out. I had to use the bathroom, so I was like, excuse me. And I was in the bathroom, and then when I came back, I was like, thank you. And then we started talking. He was like, what do you do? And I was like, this and this and that. And I was like, I'm a YouTuber, you know. And he was like, oh, interesting, you know. Like, well, they call it social media influencer, you know. So we were talking, and I said, what do you do? And he was like, well, I'm here, you know, I'm coming on a business trip to, I guess, something, create something or whatever, some sort of, like, whatever. He was in a medical field, and I think he was, like, creating some sort of lotion or some sort of cream to heal wounds and burn marks and stuff like that. And he was trying to get into cosmetic a little bit, because whatever they're created, I guess it was good, and he's, you know, he was into that. So I asked him, I said, well, have you tested on animals yet? And he was like, no. I was like, oh my God, that's amazing. And I was like, to explain to him how you don't need to test on an animal and you could do this without doing it, go cruelty free. And I was like, oh my gosh, once your product comes out, send it to me and I will talk about it on my show, but I can only do that if you're cruelty free, vegan. You know what I mean? So I got him really like getting involved about how vegan movement is getting big and how it's important to, you know, make a product, a new product that's cruelty free. And then he totally understood what I was saying. And he was like, yeah, okay. Yeah, I'm glad that I didn't test it on the animals yet. And I don't think I will. And he is not planning to. And when I was done with that conversation, when I got off the plane, I felt so good, you know, because that's one company already that's already like veganizing, you know. That made me realize, doesn't matter who you are, where you are, you could do this in a very, very quietly, quiet voice, you know. So that was very interesting for me. The whole LA trip was amazing. And I wanted to do this drinking green juice because that's what I drank seriously almost every day. Like I drank like maybe two or three. Some days I even drank two green juice. Yeah, for breakfast I had green juice and for lunch I had green juice. And because I had meetings at night, you know, went to dinner, I ate just regular meal. But yeah, so try to drink lots of green, you guys. Green is so good for you. If you want to lose weight, greens, okay? If you want to have amazing skin, green, okay? If you want to have maybe healing from, you know, your illness, green. Green is amazing. Opportunities like this come for me and it's amazing. I never knew when I turned 41 that these things will happen to me. I really never knew that. Like even last year or year before that, I was like, you know? So always dream big, always spread love, and always dream green, I guess. I'll see you later, guys. Oh, I hope I don't forget anything. Vegan festival. What's up?
Hi.
Hi.
Hi. I love you.
I love you too.
You're so beautiful.
Thank you. Ooh. Whoa. Vegan kimchi.
Yay.
Other love.
What's up?
We can be alright. Cause when it gets dark and when it gets cold, we'll each other till we see the sun. I can tell you're tired of being lonely. Take my hand, don't let go, baby, hold me. Come to me, let me be your and only. So I can meet all right till the morning. I can tell you're tired of being lonely. Take my hand, don't let go, baby, hold me.